Speaking of another member of our team, today is National Running Day, and whether you've been running for a while or you're just starting out, we've got some timely tips for you.
Our Tom Barnes is live at Dick Pond Athletics with the scoop. Hey, Tom.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Doing great.
Fantastic. You don't look like you've been running. You look pretty chill.
I'm about to go on a run.
Today is
Global Running Day, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes.
I know that you guys have probably got your running shoes at the station ready to go, right?
Of course.
Ready
yeah,
to
as
hit
you
that
instructed me, yes.
Yes, so there's a lot of things that go into running. I've done a couple triathlons in my life, so I learned the hard way about certain things. And one of the most important things about running is shoes. And that's why I'm here at the Dick Pond in Park Ridge. And I'm going to talk to my friend Chris here in a second. I'm going to flip my camera around. And I'm gonna go say hi to Chris. You guys bear with me here. So Chris, you are the person I need to talk to here at Dick Pond, right?
Yeah.
So what's the importance of running shoes and everything else to make sure that you don't, you know, blow out your knees in the first 2 minutes of your run?
Yeah, shoes are definitely the most important piece of equipment you're gonna get when you run. It's really the main thing you need. So the reason why they're important is when you get fitted properly for a shoe, cushion support structure, it's going to take upwards of 95% of the shock away from the body before it gets to your knees, your joints, your hips. So we're trying to put you in the correct shoe so that it keeps you right down the center and takes all the stress off of there. So you could be one of those people that loves running instead of one of those people that just tries to get through it. So
right. And I think a lot of people are guilty of trying to get through it versus loving. So what's happening right now where you just measured his foot there and everything?
So we just measured it with I don't know how many of you guys remember getting this done. So this gives us a full measurement of his foot, left, right. We measure it while he sits and stands. And then what we'll do is we're actually going to head over here to the treadmill.
I'll follow you guys. Go ahead. Yeah. So you're going to go over the treadmill. And so what does the treadmill tell you, or what are you hoping it will tell you?
What we're going to do on the treadmill is we videotape him on the treadmill. Mm-hmm. And as it's going on the treadmill, we're going to tape it. You can see him up here on the screen. And we're going to be able to slow that down into 1/1000th of a second. And we'll be able to look at his gait. Which way to his feet?
The gait is that. It's where how his feet land.
It's how his feet strike. Do his feet strike under his body, in front of his body? Do his feet tend to roll in, roll out? All of those things can help us decide how much cushioning, how much support you need out of a shoe.
Yeah, have you guys ever done anything like this before where you check your gait? And I can't tell you how important it is. Have you guys tried that?
I actually have.
Yeah, same here. And it's a lot of fun. It's not as intimidating as it might seem.
I had a slightly different experience. They told me that I was really, I needed some help. But actually, that was kind of the neat part for me, though, is there was a benefit to it. They're like, all right, make these couple adjustments. It was about almost like a beats per minute. How quickly I was hitting the ground is what they told me I needed to work on.
Interesting.
Yeah. So Israel here, what is the gait that you looked at, Chris? What is it telling you that he should be working on when you look up on this thing here?
I'm loading it up right now.
So he's using his fancy technology over here to load us up. But as you can see, they do this for any customer that wants to come in. They'll do this where you get to watch your gait. And you can see how he's striking. I don't know if you guys can see with the glare of the screen there. I'll try to get it up here.
And actually, if you or maybe Chris.
This is showing us the angle. You know, if his ankles, if his knees, if his hips are staying in line. If this foot begins to roll in, it tells us he needs more or less support. And then what we're going to do is we actually videotape him over here as well.
Okay. Go ahead, Chip. What were you saying?
I was going to say, maybe you or Chris could even break down gait just a little bit more, because I know there's a lot of factors. It's not literally just like the distance between your strides. There's a lot more to it.
Break down gait a little bit more for me, if you can just explain it for people who might have never run before. Go for it.
Actually,
and you can even show them. Oh, you got look at this. Right? Visual aids, guys.
So ideally what would happen when you run is you're going to land more on the outside of that foot, and you're going to strike to the center. As that foot strikes in, that's called pronation. Mm-hmm. We're hoping that your foot rolls or pronates in a little bit. The reason for that is as that foot comes down, as it pronates, that's your body's way of naturally dispersing that shock and weight. If you come straight down, that shock is going to go right to the knees, right into the hips. So
we're lower back.
Lower back, all that.
Everything hurt. That hurts on my body,
yeah.
Just walking.
Everything that hurts on everyone. So the goal is to see that foot land, strike, hit center, and stop rotating. Most of us, though, we continue to rotate past that center point. Mm-hmm. The more we roll past center, you start to notice, if you come through center, when that knee rolls in or that foot rolls in, the knee becomes out of alignment. Usually that hip drops a few degrees and the lower back. This is why so many runners say, bad hip, I got the runner's back, I got the runner's knee. So if you are one of those people, we notice it and we can get you in a shoe that's more structured on the medial side, mm-hmm. which is going to stop, it's going to correct, and it's going to put you in a neutral gait.
And that's what this machine here comes into, to avoid injuries like shin splints or tendonitis. That hurts like for weeks, months, or even a year, right?
Oh, yeah. The joke I always tell is, anyone know who Joakim Noah is? I think he missed like 3/4 of a season.
Chicago Bulls.
With plantar fasciitis. And I tell people, I don't know what you do for a living, but Joakim Noah was making $15 million a year, and they couldn't figure out how to get him on a basketball court with plantar fasciitis. So there's no way that, you know, us running our 9-minute, 10-minute, 12-minute miles, it's going to go away. It's just, it takes a lot of time. What plantar fasciitis is it's basically when you have your muscles are shortened in the back of your calf and your Achilles. So what happens is when you rest that foot, or like women who wear high heels, you know, that tendon becomes shorter, and it becomes more like a rope and less elastic. So what happens is you begin to tear it instead of it stretching. So let's try to get a more elastic.
So this machine here helps you figure out what you need in terms of the proper shoe. There's also, go ahead, run through that real quick because we have to wrap, but they're wrapping me up. So I just want to be able to show this real quick.
So this kind of gives you an idea of your arch height, the width of your foot, the length of your foot. It has a bunch of scanners and cameras around it.
And it gets your shoe. So real quick, the more expensive shoe, not the better necessarily, right?
Sometimes the $99 shoe is the best bet. Sometimes you need to spend a little bit money, spend a little more money. But yeah, I would definitely say get into a shoe store that, like Dick Pond, we'll get you on a treadmill, we'll videotape you, we'll make sure your money's spent the best way possible.
And today is Global Running Day. You guys have an event outside. You have a running group here in the Park Ridge area where people come out, run. You could barbecue and the whole thing today, right?
Yeah, today we're doing Global Running Day. It's once a year. We have fun runs every Monday and Wednesday, but tonight we're actually benefiting Mercy Home for Boys and Girls downtown.
They're I'm just going to show this as you're talking.
They're our charity partner. So if you come in tonight, we have an optional donation for $5, and then you can get a bucket.
Awesome. So there you go, guys. What do you think? Do you guys, you all set with your running gear for this summer?
No. No,
I'm
going
to need to make a stop in there, get everything that I need, and get my feet measured again.
Yes.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, they do have everything, and it's super easy. You can come in right here. They'll take care of you. They have plenty of shoes, plenty of running gear. And I will tell you firsthand account experience, shoes matter. And it's not always the most expensive one. So there's your tip for the day.
Appreciate it, Tom. So details of Dick Pond Athletics up on the screen right now, 575 Busey Highway, dickpondathletics.com. And always tune in to some of Tom's Chicago scene stuff for really interesting places around Chicago. Thanks again.
Thanks, Tom.
Please do. Thanks, guys.